structural adjustment, the effects of structural adjustment policy on poor countries has been one of the most significant criticism of the World Bank. The 1979 energy crisis plugged in many countries into the economic crisis. The World Bank responded with the structural adjustment loan, which is distributed aid to struggling the countries while enforcing policies change in order to reduce the inflation and fiscal imbalance. Some of these policies included encouraging production, investment and labor intensive manufacturing, changing real exchange rates and the altering the distribution of the government resources. Structural adjustment policies were most effective in the countries with an institutional framework that allowed these policies to be implemented easily. For some countries, particularly in sub-Saharan Africa, institutional framework that allowed these policies to be implemented easily is the for some countries, particularly sub-Saharan Africa, economic growth regressed and inflation worsened and the elevation of the poverty was not a goal. A structural adjustment loan and the circumstances of the poor often worsened due to the reduction in the social spending and the increase in the price of the food, and subsidies were lifted. By the late 1980s, international organization began to admit the structural adjustment policies were worsen life for the world's poor. The World Bank changed structural adjustment loans, allowing for the social spending to be maintained and encouraging a slower change to the policies, such as the transfer of subsidies and price rise. In 1999, the World Bank and the IMF introduced the poverty reduction strategy paper's approach to replace the structural adjustment loans. The poverty reduction strategy paper approach has been interpreted as an extension of a structural adjustment policies, as it continues to reinforce and legitimize global inequalities. Neither approach has addressed the internal inherent flaws within the global economy that contributes to the economic and social inequalities within the developing countries. Fairness of assistance condition. Some critics, most prominently the author Naomi Kallen, are of the opinion that the World Bank Group's loans and the aids have unfair condition attached to them that reflect the interest, financial power and the political doctrine. Notable, the Washington consensus of the bank and the extension of the countries that are most influential within it, among other allegations. Kallen says the group's credibility was damaged when it forced school fees on students in Ghana in exchange for loans, when it demanded that the Tanzania privatize its water system, when it made telecom privatization a condition of aid for Hurricane Mitch, when it demanded labor flexibilities in Sri Lanka in the aftermath of the Asian tsunami, when it pushed for the eliminating food subsidies in post-invasion Iraq, the sovereign immunity. The World Bank requires sovereign immunity from the countries it deals with. The sovereign immunity wipes a holder from the all legal liabilities for their reduction. It is proposed that this immunity from the responsibilities is a shield which the World Bank wants to resort to for escaping accountabilities and security by the people, and as the United States has veto power, it can prevent the World Bank from the taking action against its interests. PricewaterhouseCoopers. What World Bank favored the PricewaterhouseCoopers as a consultant in the bid for the privatizing the water distribution in Delhi in India.